Good morning, Colonel Bai.
It's Tuesday, September the 21st.
I'm Adam.
And I'm Edwin.
And here are your morning announcements. It's that time of the year where Colonel Bai's clubs are starting up. Before they are officially up and running, the virtual club fair will be taking place this Thursday and Friday from 5 p.m. to 6:35 p.m. More information regarding the club fair can be found on the club directory, which is on the Colonel Bai website.
Speaking of clubs, the Sexuality and Gender Alliance Club will be taking place this year. To join, use the link to the sign-up form on screen, or you can contact Cassander for more information.
Tideco's monthly video contests are back. Send your best 15-second video with your best dance moves to the CB Tideco Instagram page for a chance to win prizes from the den.
Get those dances in, Cougars. The last date for course changes for your day 1 or 2 classes is Tuesday, September the 28th. Complete the course change request form on the CB website under School News. Virtual guidance appointments can also be made on the CB guidance page. Bring a device to the Learning Commons to have your virtual guidance appointment.
No student who deserves some extra recognition? Email Mr. Barrett to nominate them for Cougar of the Week.
Students who park at school must register their vehicles on the Google form on the school websites under the news section.
That's all from us today, CB. Now here's your sports desk.
What's up, sports fans?
I'm Sam.
And I'm Mike.
And this
is your sports desk. Hey, Sam, I heard you like football, right?
Mike, I love football. I watch it every Sunday.
Well, then, you're going to love this next piece on our CB football program. Let's roll that.
There's a moment in your bones when. Colonel Bai has a long-standing tradition of an excellent football program. Prior to the COVID shutdown, our Cougars competed in 4 consecutive city championship games from 2016 to 2019, including winning back-to-back titles in 2017 and 2018. Each year, Colonel Bai's football team graduates student athletes who are recruited and go on to play and study at university programs across Canada and the United States, including current University of Ottawa, GG's captain Daniel Oladejo, and current Rutgers University defensive end Renee Conga. While COVID may not permit us to have a team this year, there'll be an interest meeting for anyone in grades 9 to 12 who wishes to become part of the football program today at 12:05 by joining the meet code CB Football. Everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him
more than anybody against us. We certainly do have a long-standing tradition of successful CB football programs. The plan for this year is to start practices back up in the fall and then in the winter, and to have games back up in the spring. So if you are interested in joining the CB football team, please join the Google Meet today at 12:05 using the code CBFootball.
Anyways, Sam, are you planning on joining any CB sports teams this year?
Of course I am, Mike. I'm planning on joining the football team and maybe even joining the chess club.
How many times do I have to go over this, Sam? Chess is not a proper sport.
Mike, I'll tell you 100 times. Chess is a sport. They even play it in the Olympics. What do you guys think, Cougars? Email us at our sports desk email if a chess is a sport or not.
Anyways, speaking of CB sports, we've got a great interview coming up for you right after this segment to hear what our students think of our CB sports teams. Let's go check that out.
What's up, Cougars? It's Sam from Sports Desk. Today I got the chance to interview some CB students about how they feel about school sports. Let's go check that out.
Hi there. I'm here with
Alexander Mogadam.
Omar Rashwan.
Ali, grade 12.
Julia, grade 12.
Ali Kalkas.
Amira.
Tara.
Abdullah.
Nesrat.
Sienna.
Madvi.
Lavanna.
Annika.
Hi, Annika. So do you think sports are going to come back to Colonel Bai at all this year?
I really hope so. I didn't get to do any last year because it was COVID, and then it's my second year at Colonel Bai, and I really hope that they get to come back.
I'm sure a lot of the outdoor sports can come back considering it's spaced out, and hopefully the indoor ones like basketball, volleyball can come back too.
I mean, I don't know.
I hope so.
Now, if sports were to come back, which ones do you think you guys would play?
I used to play soccer, but I definitely go for basketball. That's all I play right now.
100%, yeah, soccer, basketball. If there's touch football for girls, then yeah.
Junior girls, basketball, and hopefully volleyball, maybe.
I want to do volleyball, but I don't think there's going to be for juniors, so.
Yeah, volleyball.
Yeah, volleyball too.
Volleyball for all three of you guys?
Probably track and field, and if there's a downhill ski team, probably that too.
Probably basketball and soccer.
Same here, basketball and soccer.
Field hockey and soccer.
I think I could get into track and field or just sit in the bleachers, yeah.
Yeah, so I was planning on maybe playing football because I'm like small but fast, you know?
Yeah, obviously I play basketball, so most likely basketball and maybe volleyball.
I think I will be joining a few sports teams. Not a few, actually. I will probably be only joining volleyball.
Yeah, I'm going to join volleyball, so Madame McCaff. And soccer.
Thank you, everyone, for your interviews today, and let's send it back to the desk.
Wow, that was pretty cool. Right, Sam?
I know, right? That interviewer, he was awesome.
That's not exactly what I meant.
What?
It's fine. Anyways, up next, Cougars, we've got a brand new segment called Obscure Sport of the Month.
Let's go check that out.
Cheese rolling. The Obscure Sport of the Month originates in the 19th century of Gloucester, England, and takes place on every spring bank holiday on Cooper's Hill. Essentially, the sport is the act of rolling a 9-pound of double Gloucester cheese down a 200-yard hill while competitors chase it. Originally, the goal was to catch the cheese. However, with its 1-second head start and how quickly it gained speed, it was changed to crossing a finish line at the bottom, where the winner wins the cheese roll. The 9-pound cheese can reach speeds of 110 kilometers per hour, where many racers have actually been injured by it, resulting in a foam replica being used in 2013. Although the sport may be obscure, competitors all around the world come to the small town each year to compete. In fact, a Canadian won one of the races in 2019, taking home the giant cheese. That's all for Obscure Sport of the Month. See you next time.
Man, what a good sport.
Oh yeah? Well, I'd be totally feta than you.
Oh haha. That's enough of the cheesy puns for now.
And unfortunately, Cougars, the cheesy puns aren't the only thing that's going to end right now. That's all we have for you this week, CB.
This is your sports desk.
Signing off.